three. A little bit. Nah, yo, what's good with you guys? It's J-Rose here. Different setting though, you feel me? A little different setting. Not necessarily a B video today, but I wanted to answer the number one question I get, which is, how do I get into modeling, or how did I personally get into modeling? So I guess I wanna just answer that question. I'm gonna start doing a little bit more modeling content on here as well, mixing with my beats as well. So if you guys have any modeling questions for me, like how did I start, like would I get paid? Whatever questions you want, just hit my phone, you feel me? Hit me in the DMs at I am J Roach on all platforms. You can leave a comment, whatever, I'll answer any questions. So I'm definitely gonna try to kind of give y'all B videos, B vlogs, vlogs of my life, and then also some question type of thing. Definitely want to give all those gems to you guys and start giving back to you guys, because I feel like I'm in a place where I can not only talk about what I've gone through in the past, I say year and a half, almost 2 years, but like I feel like I'm in a place that I can show a little bit of a testimony to, like, you know, not that I'm just like bullshitting, you know what I'm saying? I guess I have a little bit more credibility now. So without further ado, let's get into it. So how did I personally start modeling? So we're gonna get into the long story, I guess. So me and my boy, Mike Hodgman, follow him. I'll put his at under here, but he's a dope photographer. Back in college, I think my first picture with him was with his iPhone, cause he didn't know how to take pictures either. He just took one with the iPhone. And I think it was December 2015, right into 2016. No, maybe? Yeah, right into 2016. So yeah. So with no intentions of modeling, he had no intention of really photographing, whatever. We just kind of were doing it because we wanted some gram photos and stuff like that. Long story short, we just keep on taking pictures. And then I go to LA in 2018 for spring break with my boys, just to visit, because I've always wanted to go to LA. And one of my homegirls here, shout out to Emma. So one of my homegirls here, we linked with her and she was like, oh my God, like you should model, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, what you mean? Like I've heard, like my mom told me I should model, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't know like what was good with it. I didn't know if you could make money. I was just like, yo, I'm going to school for basketball. I don't care about anything else. And she was like, yo, send me some of the pictures that, or show me some of the pictures that you take. And I showed her some of the pictures that me and Mike were taking, you know what I'm saying, back, you know, for the past, you know, I guess year at that point, year and a half. I showed her the past, you know, pictures from like past year. And she was like, oh my gosh, like these are good. Like I'm gonna help you put a portfolio together. Portfolio is just basically a book of your pictures. So she helped me put that together. And then she was like, yo, let's just go walk. Like we picked one day, one random day. And she was like, let's go drive and walk down these streets and go to these, walk down the streets of LA, like on Wilshire, maybe Sunset, and just go find these top agents. We basically door knocked for like 4 hours, got some good responses. Long story short, I ended up getting in contact with her mother agent, who she started with in Pennsylvania, Mainline Models. Yeah, I signed with that mother agency probably a month after spring break, so probably March. So I move fast. That's one of the things I tell people is like, yo, like you want a dream, you gonna get it, you gonna do it. So basically my dream was obviously always to be an entertainer. In the back of my mind, just never knew it was possible until she put it in my head. And so a month later, I found myself traveling from Christopher Newport University to Pennsylvania, like almost 2 to 3 times, almost 4 times a month. So she can groom me, give me some acting lessons, give me some modeling lessons, whatever. And then her plan was to take me to New York to this place called IMTA. I forget what the acronym, but IMTA is basically this huge scouting event with thousands of international agents and managers and scouts just looking for new talent, you know? We prepared from March to, I think IMTA was the beginning of July. And fortunate enough, you know, I had my parents' support with everything. Like my mom was always supportive. My dad was always supportive, you know what I'm saying? Financially and just like telling me like, yo, you can do it. You don't have to like worry about any of the other haters, that you can go do it. So that was the biggest thing. Fast forward to July 2018, we go to IMTA, and basically the whole week is just auditions, you know what I'm saying? Since you're in New York City and everybody knows that event is going on, there's random casting directors there. And so basically on that Friday, I had like 30 or 40 agents that like wanted to call back and or wanted to talk to me. And so we went there. Long story short, all that is basically just getting to know them, being yourself, and taking digital pictures. Just like pictures of you with your shirt off, just no makeup, just no filter. Basically, they want to see what you look like. Fast forward, I get an email from M2M Studios, who was at IMTA. They was like, yo, all you gotta do is get your plane ticket here and just find a place to stay. We'll do your acting reel for free, blah, 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 blah. And I was like, say that. So I flew to LA, stayed with my homegirl, Emma. Shout out to Emma. Did my reel and told my mother agent, Lorraine, that I was in LA. And she pulled some strings to get me in the building with this agency called Maverick. Long story short, I signed with Maverick in July 2018. And they were like, yo, when are you coming to LA? And I was like, yo, I have one more semester of school. So signed with them, was planning on coming back to LA. So I finished school in December 2018. With all intention of just going to LA right after. I didn't take any of the engineering jobs that I got because I knew I was gonna stay there long term, and I knew that I wanted something that I could have time to myself to work on what I wanted to work on. I worked at TGI Fridays from like January to April, saved up around like $5,000, moved to LA. Long story short, I moved to LA, didn't hear from this agency that I signed to in July, didn't hear from them for like, since realistically like September, you know? And I just moved basically because I was like, yo, I need to get out of here. I want to do this. I'm trying to do music. I'm trying to do modeling. I need to get in the entertainment business. I need to go to LA. Backtrack. So after I got signed to that agency in July 2018, I got my first gig, but it wasn't from them. It was from my cousin Kyle. She worked for Buck Mason, which is a clothing company based in LA. And while I was in school, they basically flew me out. I had a place to stay. Again, I stayed at Emma's spot, and they basically took photos of me. Like it wasn't an e-com shoot, but it was more of an editorial shoot. Well, it was an editorial shoot. And that was my first real shoot that I had gotten flown out to LA for. And that shoot propelled me forward because once I did that shoot and I did a little test shoot with one of her photographers, that was my book. And so my second day in LA was insane because the photographer who shot me for Buck Mason, that photographer was just like, yo, like your look is amazing. Like, and your agency is shitty. And let me just be real. Let me put you on to this other agency. I'm gonna set up an appointment with her. Her name is Katie. She's with Two Management, whatever. I'm like, oh, that's fire. And shit, like I love Katie's vibe. She was the nicest person. She like so caring, you know what I'm saying? And then like, so we basically hit it off and I signed with them. This is now the second week I'm in LA. I have an apartment. I have an agency and I'm just like, now I'm living in LA. So that's really how I started. Long-winded video, but that's literally how I started. I had to like kind of reel it back in as I was speaking about it, because I don't really talk about it in this in depth. But yeah, that's how I started in the modeling industry. First year is pretty rough, you know, but now getting into my like 18th, 19th month here in LA, things are starting to pick up for sure. Like I said in the last video, just recently I did Abercrombie, Old Navy, Tom Brown, Aloe Yoga. I just got on GQ and Vogue this past week. So it's just been insane. Yeah, it's been insane really. So I'm hoping to keep on going up. If you guys have any modeling questions, or if you guys just want more of this type of content, like me answering y'all's questions about modeling or the industry or whatever, or what I've learned about me being in LA, hit me in the DM, hit me in the comments. I would love to answer all these questions, bro. So, hey, shit, stay blessed, stay creative, stay positive, because that's how you're gonna get to where you wanna be. So, hit me, peace.